In light of her newfound freedom, Princess Holly fell in love with the forest. Yet, she still felt as though the beady eyes of another were all but far from this magical place. No matter how far she ran from her mother's castle, it seemed she could not shake off the trail of the snake. But this snake was her mother's snake. And that meant it wasn't just any snake, this was a magic snake. As she explored the woods, the snake sought to take more of a comforting form.
Your Highness, are you hurt? Please, I only want to help.
That of Grace.
What are you doing here?
An old friend.
Just take my hand.
Acquaintance.
Are you alright for Sir Hare?
Of course.
So what are you writing?
A story.
About me.
Through here, Your Highness.
It's an apple.
Indeed. Servants had been planting the seeds for many years. There was once a whole orchard, much like the one by the castle, only your mother had them all destroyed. All but one sapling had prospered through the years and turned into one mighty, lifeful tree.
It's from the castle, you say?
Yes. Do you want it, Your Highness?
Yes.
Then take it.
Can I?
No.
But you said I could.
No, I didn't. Whether you should or you shouldn't,
That doesn't mean that you can't. But if you want to prove to them that you're not the monster that they think you are, you ought not to.
What a dirty trick. I ought to take it just so you can't.
By all means. But we both know I'm the last bastion of hope that you haven't left. I intend to report to them every move you make.
That doesn't mean they'll believe you.
I was your scullery maid. They'll believe every word I utter.
Who are they, anyway? Who are they to decide who I am?
They're the people, Your Highness. They're the ones that killed the Queen. Don't think they'll hesitate when they get their hands on you. You're just as evil as she was.
Don't ever call me that.
What? Evil? You're just like her. But what's worse is they know that you're worse. The evil queen and her damn daughter. You were evil the moment you were born.
Stop!
You don't seriously think that I don't know where you got off to? We live in the same household, even Mum knows.
There it is! The evil princess finally lives up to her title.
No!
What was it she said again?
I thought I raised you to be better, but evil is all I have raised.
I don't recognize you. In my moment of need, I see no love.
But evil, child.
Oh, Nabby.
This is depressing.
I love you, Holly. I'll always love you, but I can't love you, you've become. They're killing me for my wrongdoing. No kidding. But I see now, you are my wrongdoing.
Is that what I am? I'm the most evil of the lot. I should be.
Mum uses those words for a reason. Holly, sometimes you can't just be a bit uptight.
So, that's it then? I'm just uptight?
Well, I don't know. I know it's bloody annoying when you are, but...
Maybe that's just it. Maybe I am just uptight. That's just me.
Sure you don't mean to be. I mean, Mum...
Oh, she just thinks I'm evil.
No, I don't think she should call you names. There was no need for her to call you uptight.
But you agree with her?
Well, yeah. I mean, you're not evil, anyway, even if you think you are in your fancy red coat.
So, if I just make sure I'm not uptight from now on...
That's you. I mean... Mum will forgive you. She forgets how much of a pain in the arse she can be sometimes.
Like mother, like daughter.
Well, she's my mum too. And don't get me wrong, I can be a pain in the arse sometimes. So what are you writing?
It's a fantasy story, really. About someone who did some bad things and they tried to prove to people that they weren't just as evil.
How does it end?
The main character loses.
Oh.
Although, I am thinking of changing the ending.
What's wrong with it?
It doesn't feel quite right anymore.